was a rather nice surprise, wasn't it? Those 9 dancers are from Walther's Bachelor of Performing Arts Performance Making course. So they're not just dancers, they're actors, directors, they write their own shows, they design them, they work out the costuming, the staging, the lighting, so they're all about studying all aspects of performance from all around the world. So it's a delight to have them here performing with us tonight. So this is the last time you'll hear from me before intervals. So I thought I would just do some housekeeping. There is an interval. The bar will be open upstairs. There are 4 shows on at Whopper tonight, though. So if you're standing upstairs and there's still a lot of people around, they might be there for another show. So do come back to us within 15 minutes for some wonderful music from around the world, percussion in the second half. At the foot of the stairs as you go down, there's a little desk with some pieces of paper on it. If you'd like to join the 1,000 people who are on our email news list, you are most welcome, because we love to stay in touch with you. And I'm going to ask Michael out to come now, because he's going to tell us about a very special place in the world we're going to travel back to now.
We're going to go to a slightly different mood now, much quieter. We'll be relieved to know that the next few moments are nice and gentle and quiet. These were inspired by the trip I took with my son to Kathmandu to actually search for some singing bowls. I love these very special instruments from the Himalayan region of Nepal, and they're often shipped up into Tibet and down into northern India. The first piece, though, the first of 3 pieces originally, we're only doing 2 tonight, is called Swayambhu, Dawn Bhajan. Swayambhunath is a Buddhist temple complex in Kathmandu, and we went there at dawn. It's a beautiful thing to do in Kathmandu, to walk up these very numerous steps to get up to the complex under a canopy of red flags. When we got to the top, there was monkeys. This is also called the Monkey Temple. And there was very beautiful, gentle music with a combination of harmonium, flute, cymbals, tabla, and voices singing this lovely Hindu hymn. The next movement after that is something quite dark, called Pashupati, inspired by the this time Hindu complex on the Bagmati River. This is after the uplifting experience of Swayambhu. Pashupati is a much kind of darker sort of experience where they cremate the bodies on the river. So standing across the river from the ghats or the platforms where the bodies are burned, it's a very beautiful scene of cows in the river, children bathing in the river, people washing in the river while the bodies are being burned, and the families stand by waiting. Sadhus pass by, heavily painted and walking with tridents. It's very beautiful, the dark atmosphere. So here we go with Swayambhu, followed by Pashupati. Thank you.
Thank you. Can I move?